Recursion occurs when a function calls itself, solving smaller and smaller subproblems each time. Take a look at this triangle. It's a bit plain right now, so let's create a new pattern, following a rule to always remove the middle part of the triangle. After applying this rule once, we get this pattern. What if we ran the rule again, but this time on all three smaller triangles? We get this even more complex pattern. Every consecutive time we call this rule, we're dealing with smaller and smaller subtriangles. This is exactly what recursion is. In fact, this triangle is called Sierpinski's triangle and is a well-known pattern created using recursion. Recursive functions contain two important things, a base case and a recursive case. The base case is a set of instructions that tells the recursion to stop, and the recursive case is a set of instructions that allows the recursion to continue. Let's relate this to our Sierpinski triangle. Our recursive case is the set of instructions that will cause the function to run over and over with the smaller triangles each time, and our base case will tell the function to stop once we've reached the smallest size. Here's what it might look like in pseudocode. Our function takes in the size of a triangle as a parameter. The if statement is our base case, which stops the recursion. And the else statement is our recursive case, which continues the recursion. If we ran the function with a starting size of 3 and a min size of 1, the computer would start with this triangle of size 3 and remove the middle of it, which would create 3 new triangles all of size 2. Then, the function runs again, but this time operates on all of the size 2 triangles, removing their middles and creating 9 new triangles all of size 1. The function runs one last time, this time operating on triangles with a size of 1. Here, our size now equals our min size, so we've reached our base case and we should now stop the recursion. Recursion is an important algorithmic concept that many software engineers never learn, because in popular languages like Python, JavaScript, and Java, iteration is used far more than recursion. Iteration is using a loop to repeatedly execute the same instructions, like for loops and while loops. While recursion can solve the same problems as iteration, recursion is more commonly used for functional programming, including languages like Haskell, OCaml, and Clojure. There are advantages and disadvantages to using recursion, but that is outside the scope of a 2-minute summary. If you want to see that in a different video, be sure to let me know in the comments down below. This has been Recursion in 2 Minutes. Thanks for watching, and hit the subscribe button and the notification bell to stay up to date with the latest videos. Thanks, and see you in the next one.